Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel and my new video series on mastering linear algebra with NumPy. In this video, I will discuss installing Anaconda with Python 3 on Ubuntu 22.04, and how to set up the NumPy package and Jupyterlab inside the Anaconda environment. Alright, let's get started. Let's open Anaconda website first. As you might have heard, Anaconda is an open-source package manager, environment manager, and distribution of the Python and R programming languages. It is commonly used for data science, machine learning, large-scale data processing, and scientific computing. It has free distribution for students and educational users, and paid versions for professionals and enterprises. For example, the free distribution offers more than 8,000 data mining and machine learning packages. For this video series, we need free distribution, so we're good and don't need to pay a penny. The Anaconda distribution comes with the conda command line utility. You can learn more about Anaconda and conda by reading the official Anaconda documentation. Today, I will share my experience with installing Anaconda correctly because I tried a few installation guidelines, and most of them either didn't work or were incomplete. From the lessons I learned, I would say the best practice to install Anaconda is to download the latest Anaconda installer bash script, verify it, and then run it. Alright, let's do it step by step. Step 1. You need to get the latest version of Anaconda with Python 3 from the Anaconda website. Go to the Products section, then Anaconda Distribution, and right-click on Download and copy the link. For example, at the time of recording this video, the latest version is 2022.05, but you should be able to use a later stable version if it is available. Step 2. Open a terminal in a Linux environment and change to the Tmp directory on your terminal. In fact, this is a good directory to download temporary items, like the Anaconda bash script, which you won't need after running it. Step 3. Use curl to download the link we copied from the Anaconda website. Let's output this to a file called anaconda.sh for quicker use. So, you can type this command in your terminal. Step 4. We can now verify the data integrity of the installer with cryptographic hash verification through the SHA-256 checksum. We can use the SHA-256 sum command along with the file name of the script. Then, you will receive output that looks similar to this. One thing we can do here to ensure we have the correct output. Let's check the output against the hashes available at the Anaconda with Python 3 on the 64-bit Linux page for your appropriate Anaconda version. Then, we're good to go if our output matches the hash displayed in the SHA-256 row. Let's check ours for Linux 64-bit. Cool! All good. In step 5, run anaconda.sh script using bash command. The output will be like this. Then, you should press enter to continue, and then press enter to read through the license. Once you're done reading the license file, it will be prompted to approve the license terms and ask if you approve the license terms. To approve, type yes. In choosing the installation location, you will be prompted to choose the location of the installation. I would press enter to accept the default location, or you could specify a different location if you want. the installation process will continue. However, note that it may take some time. Step 6. Once the installation is complete, you will receive the message asking us if you want to initialize Anaconda 3. Type yes so that you can initialize Anaconda 3. After that, you will receive some output that states changes made in various directories. Finally, one of the lines you receive will say thank you for installing Anaconda. Step 7. In this step, you can activate the installation by sourcing the bash rc file. Once you have done that, you'll be placed into the default base programming environment of Anaconda, and your command prompt will change to the base environment. I want to mention that, although Anaconda comes with this default base programming environment, you should be able to create separate environments for your programs and keep them isolated. You can further verify your installation by using the conda command. For example, with the list command, we can call conda list. This will list the output of all the packages you have available through the Anaconda installation. Perfect. Now that we have Anaconda installed, let's set up Anaconda environments. As I mentioned, Anaconda virtual environments allow us to keep projects organized by Python versions and the packages needed. For each Anaconda environment you set up, you can specify which version of Python to use and keep all your related programming files together within that directory. First, you can check which Python versions are available for use by calling conda search Python. If you run this command, you'll receive output with the different versions of Python that you can target, including both Python 3 and Python 2 versions. However, since we are using the Anaconda with Python 3 for this video series, you will have access only to the Python 3 versions of packages. Next, let's create an environment using the most recent version of Python 3 and NumPy. We can achieve this by assigning version 3 to the Python argument. Let's call the environment linelg. To do this, we will use conda create dash dash name linalg python equals 3 numpy. Now, we will receive output with information about what is downloaded and which packages will be installed, and then be prompted to proceed with yes or no. The conda utility will now fetch the packages for the environment and let us know when it's complete. When completed, we can activate our new environment by typing conda activate linalg. With our environment activated, our command prompt prefix will reflect that we are no longer in the base environment but in the new one that we just created. Within the environment, we can verify that we're using the version of Python that we had intended to use by calling python dash dash version. We can also inspect all the environments we have set up by calling conda info dash dash ins. For linear algebra, we are going to use Jupyter. Here, I would like to set up Jupyterlab. Jupyterlab is the next generation of the Jupyter Notebook that fixes many usability issues of the Jupyter Notebook. To do this, run this command. Pip install Jupyterlab. Finally, we can also deactivate our Anaconda environment by typing conda deactivate. It will go back to the base environment. Alright, this is the end of this video. Thank you for watching my videos and supporting the channel. If you haven't, Please subscribe to the channel for upcoming videos and give thumbs up for videos. Looking forward to the following video.